Hey, everybody, resurrection people. It's Tuesday night. It's time for a little time with God and letting Him speak to us. I'm standing out here on the dock. I want to show you the lake. Isn't that just peaceful, calm? I mean, it's pretty still. It's a pretty still evening. The storm just went through. I mean, a storm was just an hour ago. I was sitting in the parking lot for prayer. Lightning, thunder, lots of rain. Some people said hail. Yeah, I mean, it was a really interesting. I love to see lightning and thunder. I don't know what it is about it, but I love to watch it. I love to see that. I love the cracking sound and everything that's happening. And yet now it's past. It's not there anymore. I mean, skies are clearing up. Things are happening. I did. I'm live. Like this? Oh, my wife is coaching me from the far side. Rotate your phone. You can't turn your phone while recording. Sorry. I got to take it back like this. Anyway, so there it is. You know what? Here's what I keep thinking of. When I think of the turbulent times that we're living in, I mean, all the things that are happening, the whole virus, the pandemic thing. When I think of you know, the injustice, people dying, you know, unjustly. And then I think of the rioting and the looting and the people losing their, I think of turbulent times. And I mean, it's not a new thing. I mean, if I look back in the Bible and I think about the Bible, I think about Noah. I mean, those were turbulent times. So things were bad. And God said, you know, I'm going to clean up the earth. I'm going to change this. But it was with water, right? And the heavens opened and the earth burst forth. And there was a tremendous flood that took place. It was with water. I think of Moses. I mean, God used water with Moses. Moses, I mean, think about it. Here's Moses is born. All the innocent children are being killed. But Moses is put in a basket because God's got a plan for him. Turbulent times. But God sends a deliverer, Moses. Moses splits the Red Sea, right? As the people of Egypt, Israel are leaving Egypt. Splits the Red Sea. Moses was in, and then I go to the New Testament. I always think this is somewhat interesting because Jesus always tells the disciples, you know, why don't you go get in the boat? Go get in the boat. You know, we're going to go to the other side. Sometimes Jesus is in the boat with them. Sometimes they're not. But you know, most often these guys are out in the boat and there's a storm and it's late at night. And I'm thinking to myself, when is somebody going to stand up to Jesus and say, hey, do you think it's such a good idea to go out in the boat this late at night? But they don't. And they walk out in faith. And the storm comes and it's turbulent times, hard times. Matter of fact, they were afraid that they were going to lose their lives, that, you know, that they were done for. They even said to Jesus at one time, when he was in the boat, don't you care? You know, that we're going to perish. We're going to die out here in this turbulent times. And, you know, Jesus stands up and he says, peace. Be still. And the waters stilled. They were calm. They were peaceful. No more rocking back and forth. No more. I mean, I'm sure an hour ago when the storm went through and the winds were kicking up and the rain was falling and the lightning and the thunder, this lake was probably a little turbulent. I would not have wanted to be out on it in a boat or anything. But now look at it. It's peaceful. It's calm. The lily pads are sitting up on top of the lake. And I'm sure there's fish underneath there. I show you that because I know that's what Jesus Christ wants to do with our turbulent times too. I know Jesus wants to bring peace. I know he wants to calm the storm in our lives. It doesn't always seem like it. We live in a fallen world. We live with sin. And yet we have a Savior who's going to come and he does stand up and he says, peace, be calm, be still. And he's going to still the storm. He'll still the storm in your heart, in your life. You got to trust him. You got to believe that he can do it. He will do it. He's going to do it. I don't know when, but I know he's going to. And he's helping people right now. He's helping people down in Minneapolis through people like you, who are going down there, making phone calls, or writing letters, or sending, you know, sending cards, sending donations. He's helping calm the storm. You know, there's one more person that I think of when I think of the winds and the waves and the water, and that's Jonah. Yeah. And it just so happens that this Sunday at Resurrection Lutheran Church in Monticello and Oak Grove, we're starting a new sermon series. And that sermon series, we're gonna talk about outrageous grace. And we're going to use the next 6 weeks, we're going to talk about Jonah. I don't know what you know about Jonah, what you think about Jonah, but we're going to preach about Jonah. So we want you to come join us for our worship time. Listen, we're going to get together. We're going to park in the parking lot. All right. We're going to be safe. Listen, if you are at risk, you know, or you're sick, that's okay. We love you. We respect you. We want to honor you. But if you want to get together with fellow believers on Sunday morning, we're going to invite you to come to the parking lot. We're going to park. We're going to ask you to bring your lawn chair. We're going to give you a parking stall and the spot right next to you. You can put your lawn chair out there and you can sit out there. We're going to tune into a FM station and we're going to be able to listen to good worship, good music. Our praise teams are going to be leading the worship and I'm going to be bringing the message on outrageous grace. If you can't join us in the parking lot or you feel it's just not time yet for you to gather together, that's okay. Watch us online. Go online. Go check us out on our Facebook page, on YouTube. Get a hold of us. Watch with us and worship with us. Because God's going to do something. God's got outrageous grace, more than you and I could ever ask or imagine. And he's going to speak to us. And guess what? This is what I know. He's going to calm the storm. He'll calm your storm. Would you pray with me? Father, thank you for your love, your grace, your mercy. It was brand new this morning. It's brand new right now. I never have to worry about running out. I never have to about running dry. You're never going to leave me, never going to forsake me, never going to forget about me. Never. Because that's who you are. And I know when there's turbulent times in my life, maybe it's not a riot. Maybe it's not looting. Maybe, I don't know, maybe it's health. Maybe I got a bad doctor's report. Maybe it's my child and my child's hurting. Lord, when I got those turbulent times, maybe it's my marriage. Lord, when I got those turbulent times, come and still the storm in my heart, my life, because I know you have the power to do so. So please, Father, in Jesus' name, amen. 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 Hey, thanks for joining us tonight. Thanks for joining me. Thanks for coming and jumping on. I'm going to ask you to pass this along, okay? Share it. Share it as far as you can on Sunday morning. Share it. Not just like it, but share it. Get everybody that you can to watch it. Check it out. Join in with us, okay? And come join us on Sunday morning, either online or come join us in the parking lot at 9300 Jason Avenue, Northeast Monticello, or I forgot the number. It's Round Lake Boulevard over in Oak Grove, the Oak Grove campus. Come join us and celebrate with us. And remember this, don't ever forget this. God not only loves you, he likes you, and he's proud of you. Have a great evening. Bye-bye.